This is the Insta360 X4 in it's set in action camera mode. So single lens, flat color, 4K. Try and get my posture so I don't look fat. Fucking cameras can make you look fat. Fatter than you're already fat. You know what I'm saying? Don't need any help. We're out today. Benny, Jolene, the street rat, right here. This is the Fuji X-Pro 3. We've got the Polar Pro light leak lens, which I really like. We got our settings today on selective color. If you happen to remember, or around my age, in the late 70s, I was a teenager. You know, there used to be the little gift stores in a shopping mall Christmas season. Show up and look and see this amazing black and white photo of this little boy giving a little girl a red rose, and everything is black and white except that red rose. I remember seeing that as a kid and being amazed. I'm set to automatic, so we're in first off, we're in yellow. We'll switch that soon. Set up in spot point metering. Oh shit, this is some bad shit, you guys. We're gonna get shit in our feet. Come on. I'm sorry. Goat heads. Bad. Wasn't paying attention. Sorry. But you guys could dodge them too, you know. So anyway, selective color is what we're doing today. We're gonna go red, orange, yellow, green, blue, whatever it offers. God, you guys, this is horrible. It's a good year for weeds, huh? That famous photograph, I don't know who did it. It was probably some Hallmark thing. It really spurred a thing. And this is film. So this is before digital photography. This was done in film. The thing that really sold the selective color photo of the little boy doing the red rose to the girl wasn't so much the red rose. It was the subject matter that mattered. The act of kindness, symbolic act with a flower that's the only red thing in the photo is impactful. And it got outplayed. It got, oh gosh, every photo it seemed like had that for the next 5 years. But nonetheless, that's what we're doing today. Selective color, it brings up an interesting dialogue. For me, I would argue to a hammer, everything does look like a nail. But I'd also argue to a nail, everything looks like a hammer. So in a neutral environment, that selective color is going to push its way forward. It's election season. There's a lot of shit going on. The photographer in me doesn't give a rat's ass what's going on, because when I have a camera and I'm out capturing the streets, I'm an anarchist, man. Not the kind that's gonna do something stupid or cause chaos. I just don't care. I don't care about the government, don't care about the election, don't care about what people do right or wrong. And I'm not out capturing anyone's wrong, because that's just not my style. It's just not my thing. Muffler boy, muffler. It's just not my thing. Hey, look at this. We got some yellow going on here. Frame it up the best we can. So there's some yellow. We'll switch off to red. Let's spin this thing around. Get busy with some photography. Listen to some music. This song really fits my mood and symbolically kind of has a way about it that's very appealing to me. There we go. Now we got the view switched around.
Yes, I would. If I could, I surely would. Mm-hmm. I'd rather be a hammer than a nail. Yes, I would. If I only could, I surely would. Thank you.
street. Yes, I would. If I could, I surely would. I'd rather feel the earth beneath my feet. Yes, I would. If I only could, I surely would.
So all I can do really is encourage you, if you feel like a nail, stop looking for hammers. They're everywhere. And if you are a hammer, just lay off the nails. You don't have to smack them all. Don't let it occupy your life. Don't let it define who you are, especially not as a photographer. So regardless of your personal opinions, your whatever system you were raised under, whatever. It's a big country with a lot of different thinkers. If you're an artist and you're the sensitive type, get to work. Use that energy for something good. One thing about the anarchist out there, he does love all the people. So take it for what it is.
Street. Yes, I would. If I could, I surely would. I'd rather feel the earth beneath my feet. Yes, I would. If I only could, I surely would.
Hopefully you understand, just talking about photography. Live your own life, do your own things, but I just encourage you to have an outlet. Mine is photography, because that's the kind of freedom I think we all long for. But for some reason, nobody wants anyone else to have it. Don't let it bog you down. Oh, look at that. Let's do a selfie right here. Come on, guys.